Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to share with you a study that found remarkable flexibility gains in just a few weeks of training. The study focused on ankle flexibility, but you could incorporate their methodology in any area you want to focus on. I'll break down exactly what they did, their key findings, and my honest opinion on whether you should incorporate this into your training or not. The study was published in the Muscle and Nerve Journal by two scientists from the Free University of Brussels. One of the main objectives of this study was to investigate the effects of a passive static routine on the ankle dorsiflexion range of motion. The participants of the study were 12 healthy subjects, aged between 21 and 35 years. They trained for 20 minutes, 5 times a week for 6 weeks, so 30 sessions in total. Their flexibility was assessed before the 30 sessions and after 10, 20, and 30 sessions. They also did an assessment 1 month after the training program to see how much of their gains will remain. The results after the training period showed a stunning 30.8% increase in flexibility. Even more, 56% of this gain came only after the first 10 sessions. So since they were doing 5 sessions per week, this 56% of the total gains came only after 2 training weeks. This is very encouraging for anyone considering starting the flexibility journey. The rest 23% came in the next 2 weeks, and the final 21% of the total gains came on the last training weeks. Finally, on the last assessment, a month after the end of the training program, they found that 74% of the gain was still present. This last piece of their findings highlights something that I often discuss with the people I train, which is that once you reach the flexibility level that you desire, it is very hard to lose it. This is very different to strength and endurance, where you lose almost everything after a few months of being inactive. So keep in mind that although it will take some extra effort to improve your flexibility, once you get there, it's almost effortless to keep it. Now back to the study, I'm gonna walk you through their exact training program and share my thoughts on it. Their program consisted of 4 exercises. First, a standing calf stretch. In this exercise, you place your target foot flat on the floor and the other leg bent to the front. Then you lean forward while keeping your back knee straight and your heel in touch with the floor. The second exercise was a standing calf stretch with foot on the wall. On this one, you simply place your foot against the wall and keep the other leg back for support. Stretch by pushing your hips toward the wall, keeping your front knee straight and your heel in touch with the floor. The third exercise was a long seated calf stretch on which you simply pull your toe from a seated position. And finally, the fourth exercise was a standing calf stretch on a step. On this one, you step on an elevated surface and allow your heel to go lower while keeping a straight knee. They did 5 sets of each of these exercises. The method they used was the passive static, so they simply held the end position for the entire set. The duration of each set was 30 seconds with 30 seconds rest interval. Finally, the stretching intensity was set at maximum for all sets. This means that the participants were instructed to stretch at their maximum range for the entire set. So, is this a magic program that everyone should be doing? To be honest, although it was highly effective, for a few reasons, I don't believe that it's optimal. So, before you go ahead and try it, I'd like to share here some constructive criticism. To start, all the exercises used stretch the calf muscles in the exact same way. So, why not just stick to one instead of using 4? As I've explained in previous videos, our muscles run like ropes from one part of our body to the other. Stretching exercises simply lengthen the muscles between those points. So, for example, to stretch your calves, you need to increase the distance of the 2 attachments of the calf muscles by closing the angle of your ankle joint while keeping your knee straight. The degree of your stretch is determined by this angle. Therefore, if you're stretching at an 80 degree angle, it doesn't matter if you're standing, seated, or in any other position. It's the same 80 degrees, and your muscles will get the exact same stretch stimulus. In that sense, I don't find their decision to include a variety of exercises particularly useful. I think that you'd get the exact same results by sticking with just one. My second objection is that they jumped straight into maximum stretching intensities. First, in my opinion, this increased the risk of injury for beginners. And second, as I have presented in previous videos, training at maximum intensities doesn't provide any additional benefit for beginners compared to training at submaximal training intensities. This has now been proven by a number of studies. In addition to the maximum stretching intensity, they also trained almost daily, which makes me wonder how the participants were able to recover in time. I assume that they were able to do it probably because they were going through a first training period with what I would characterize as newbie gains. However, I can say with certainty that for more advanced trainees working on positions like the splits, high-intensity programs need at least 48 hours between sessions. So I'm not confident that this approach would work for more advanced flexibility levels and for multi-joint exercises. My third and final issue with this program is that although it seems small, it actually adds up to a lot of time, especially if you factor in all muscle groups. The total stretch time was 10 minutes per session, but that was only for one side. So you're looking at 50 minutes of stretching per week for one side and 100 minutes for both. And that's just for the calves. What about the hamstrings, hip flexors, glutes, quadriceps, adductors, and the upper body? If you're trying to improve in multiple areas with this method, you'll end up stretching for more than 10 hours per week. Thankfully, there are far more time-efficient ways to achieve the same results. Overall, this is a high-intensity, high-volume program that uses only one training method, the passive static. This, of course, is far from what I would consider a sophisticated training plan today. However, its effectiveness demonstrates that even doing the basics under certain conditions can yield results. So, what are the conditions that made this program successful? First, the use of the passive static method, which to this day remains the most heavily researched and proven to work method. Then, the program's high volume, which compensated for the main drawback of passive static, the need for long holds to produce results. And last, the fact that it was applied to beginners and focused on a single joint position. So, if you're a beginner looking to improve your flexibility in a small number of muscles, and you have the time to train 5 times a week, then this program will probably work well for you, at least for the first training period. However, keep in mind that I recommend sticking with only one exercise per muscle group, and also start with low stretching intensities before you progress to maximum. In that case, your program will look like this. 20 sets of 30 seconds passive static stretching per muscle group with 30 seconds rest. You should do this 5 times a week. On the other hand, if you're aiming for more advanced flexibility levels, I'd recommend structuring a much shorter workout that utilizes a variety of methods and techniques. This will ensure faster progress by tapping into all 4 physiological mechanisms that increase flexibility, rather than just the one triggered by passive static stretching. In my experience, this is the only way for most people to achieve advanced flexibility levels. If you're not familiar with any methods beyond passive static, I'd recommend starting with a unique method of our training system, the contraction passive range. You'll find it in this next video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all on the next one.